All right, so we're here in Shelter Island Boatyard, and this is the video of the 41 deck salon after it's been bottom painted. So let me give you a little tour around the bottom side so you can kind of get the full detail of the vessel while it's out of the water. As you can see here, we have a very nice large rudder. This is the deep keel and deep rudder version. A very nice design to the keel, and you can kind of see how it gets fatter from the front edge and tapers down like a wing of an airplane. So a really nice design keel. A lot of surface area here too, giving you really good control and stability. Same with the keel effects of that. But you can see they brought the bottom paint all the way to the very back edge of the vessel. And then they're about 2-3 inches down from the bottom boot stripe. So the water line is probably gonna be about 6 inches below that. So really nice coverage bringing it up. But one thing that you're gonna notice here, and I kind of mentioned this in a lot of my videos, is the Jeanneaus tend to have a really nice stern reflex design. So from the aft side of the keel, if you carry this line straight, you can see the arc of the transom, how much that stern reflex is affected. So this gives you a couple different things of its control and stability underway and in following seas. Instead of having a flat bottom boat, it tends to have a lot more curvature, so it surfs and rides those waves and swells a lot better. This is the sail drive system here, and what's going to happen is after the boat gets splashed and put in the water, we're going to actually put a max prop on this. So this is what comes standard, a three-blade fixed prop, and the zinc itself, you're going to see we have two Allen heads right here, this top one and the lower one, and this is kind of what's called a butterfly zinc that goes around the sail drive. So this is what protects the sail drive right here. And then as you can see open, right now this is where it bolts through, but we have a nice little plate that gets epoxied to that, so it's going to kind of cover all this off. You still get water up inside here, but this gives a little bit more of an airfoil kind of going back, less resistance. We have the engine intake through hole that's just in front of the, this is a drain. The engine intake is actually here, built into the sail drive, sitting the standard shaft front confused. But this is another intake through hole here, and then we have our large keel. So the keel itself has a really nice design to it. You can see we have a real plum keel here, the bulb on the bottom, a nice wide surface area here and how it tapers back. But this is directly underneath the mast, so all of the weight and loads are constructed throughout the hull, and it sits right on top of the forward part of the keel. Just forward of this is our speed and depth transducer. So this is our speed paddle wheel here, and this is the depth transducer side. So before you used to have two through holes, now they've integrated it into one. This will give you a really nice look of the keel styling and design. Coming up, very similar to how the transom was, if you take this flat line edge and you take it all the way forward, you're gonna see how the bow itself has a nice reflex to it. This is like a rocker camber style shape, allowing you to come into oncoming swells and just ride that ocean a lot more. When the boat heels over, you pick up waterline and just increases its performance and speed, and you know, it's just entryway from the bow onto from what you're kind of going through into the ocean. Here we have the forward head through hole. So this large one is the holding tank, and then we have sink drain. This must be a sump overboard discharge and a head intake. A really nice, beautiful bow. Very, very plumb, like all the most modern performance race boats and performance cruisers. But really good coverage on the bottom paint. Shelter Island Boatyard is some of the best people working here, and they do a phenomenal job. And you can see here, this is this little area that we're looking at here. This is where the pads were sitting. And so they removed that this morning, and then they've come over and reapplied bottom paint here And that's why it's being held up with the crane currently right now. And the additional through holes here, this is where the aft head and shower is. Well, thank you very much for watching this video. I hope you found it helpful and informative. Once again, this is the Sun Odyssey 41 Deck Salon here in San Diego, California. After it's splashed and put in the water, it is going to be commissioned. The mast is going to be stepped with the crane, and that's going to be the next step. Thank you again, and if you have any questions about the Jeanneau product or looking to buy or sell a vessel, please feel free to contact myself, Ianvt, at any time, day or night. Once again, my number is 619-507-4416.